welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys a room tour. I know you guys have been waiting a while for my room tour ever since I moved into my sorority house about 2 months ago. This is my first time ever sharing a room with someone, so yes, I do have a roommate, and I will show you guys a little bit of her side. Ever since I knew I was going to move into Kappa Delta, I had like a Pinterest board going. So when I thought about the color palette, I definitely wanted to stick to neutrals because I feel like you can get tired of patterns very, very easily. But neutrals are evergreen, you'll love them forever. And I wanted to keep it neutral because I knew I would be getting a lot of new decor. And I wanted to kind of splurge just to have it for, you know, maybe my apartment when I get out of college. So our color palette was just like grays, golds, anything neutral. And then as you can see, there's kind of like a pop of like blush pink in the decor. So that's how we started like kind of planning out our room. And to be honest, we didn't buy a lot of this stuff until we actually got in the room. So that was definitely kind of stressful because we had 1 week to get our room ready for room tours during recruitment. Let's just say during that week, I was very broke. Even if you get stuff from like the dollar store to DIY, things just add up and you don't really realize it. So I'm definitely gonna tell you guys what I made and what I bought, and let's just get on into it. So first, I wanted to take you to my desk area where I edit videos, where I do my schoolwork, and just like watch YouTube videos or Netflix sometimes. I usually use this Big Mac to like watch like Netflix and stuff like that. Like basically it's like a TV for me. It's also really helpful when I wanna watch like lecture captures and then I can take notes on my laptop. It's definitely more motivating sitting at a desk doing work because usually it's very tempting for me to want to get in bed and edit a video or just do some of my quizzes that I have to take, but I always end up taking a nap. So yeah, I need to start coming to my desk more just to like be more productive. So that's definitely a goal I have for this year. So this trusty desk actually doubles as a vanity. So right here, I have like all my makeup in this drawer. I don't know if I would say this drawer is organized, but I definitely try. I feel like I'm always in a rush, so I just end up throwing like makeup everywhere in this drawer. You guys can probably imagine how cramped it is in here, sharing a room and just not having like as much space as you used to. Especially for me, I have so much stuff in my life and I definitely need to declutter. But while we wait for that day, I just like find anywhere that I can store stuff. So right under my desk, I have this like wooden box that I got at like some event. They were just giving it out for free, so I was like, why not? It could be cute room decor. And then I put like all my books for the semester in there. And right beside it, I store my mirror that I use to do my makeup. So that is not always on my desk because I do like to have like a clear desk if I can. I'm obsessed with this desk chair that actually came with the room. It's like a rocking chair and it's big enough to like sit crisscross applesauce. And I feel like I just get my best work done sitting crisscross applesauce, you know? Like this video if you do too. So on the chair, I have this like throw blanket that I got at the store at Home. And it's just like this big warehouse where you can find a lot of home decor stuff for a pretty reasonable price. This blanket was not a reasonable price, so I kind of contradicted myself, but it was $60. But I think it's super worth it because I can definitely take it to my apartment whenever I move out. So right behind my desk, I have my closet. And over here, I just have like a full body mirror. In my last room, this mirror was black, but I actually just spray painted it white. It was super easy to do. And then over here, I have a chair that me and Laura actually like reupholstered and DIY'd. We got this at Goodwill for like $12. And then we just painted it with some wood stain. And then Laura helped me reupholster the cushion, and I think it looks so cute, and I'm gonna use it to film because all of my decorations are a lot higher up. So I wanted a stool to make me sit higher up so that that can be in the background, if that makes sense. The only bad thing about this chair is that I don't really have much room in here to like store it, so it's just like sitting in front of my closet. So every time I want to open my doors, I have to move my chair, which isn't like awful, but you know, kind of inconvenient. So my closet is kind of messy. But I actually just got rid of like half my clothes and I made $90 at Plato's Closet, so that was really awesome. I tried to make all the like storage really efficient. So all my clothes are right here, then I have like a shoe rack over here. Then on my door, I have this like little like hanger thing and I store some miscellaneous stuff in here, and then I just hang my jewelry hanger on this. And it's so nice to just see all my jewelry kind of laid out because I never used to wear accessories, but I definitely realized that they make or break an outfit. So I love seeing all laid out like that. And then I just have some hats over here and some of my going out purses or just like little tiny handbags that aren't really everyday. Then of course on the bottom I have my hamper and just like extra hangers. And I store my book bag inside my closet on the weekends just so it's kind of like out of my space. Then I have some storage on top of my closet, which is really nice. So on this side, I just have like a lot of miscellaneous stuff. I have a lot of like jackets and sweaters in this one bag. And then I have like a crate of like my nail polish stuff. And then behind that is just like bags and my yoga mat, and then just like a roller, just like miscellaneous like fitness stuff. And over here I store my food that doesn't need to be refrigerated. So I have like my vitamins, some of my like spoons, forks and stuff, and then like cups and bowls and cereal and all that. And then on the side of my closet I do have some pictures over here just of me and Charlotte and all of our friends together. I thought it'd be really cute because it's kind of like the first thing you see when you walk into our doorway. So now onto the comfiest part of my room, my bed. I have just this white duvet cover. This is a twin XL. I decided not to get the full even though it like kind of like hangs off the bed and like covers it. We just went for the twin XLs to make it easy. And then we got this blanket from Target. It was around like $40 or something like that. But it kind of like resembles those really chunky knit blankets, which I wanted so, so bad, but they're like $300. So I was not willing to spend that much money. And then over here, we have just like a lot of like gray pillows. I also have this white back pillow, which is really nice for whenever I do want to do homework in my bed. I can like sit up and like not fall asleep. This little pillow we got on Amazon. We got this furry one from Walmart. This knit one we got from Amazon. This suede one we actually got from Bed Bath & Beyond. And then I also got the back pillow from Bed Bath & Beyond. So if you guys have been watching me since summer, you guys know me and my boyfriend actually made these headboards together. And it was really fun. It was very affordable. It was around $25 for the wood and the stain. Luckily, Ryan's grandpa had like all the tools, so we didn't have to buy that. But it was super easy to make. You just like drill some holes and paint it, and then you can have fun like distressing it. So I just added some like white specks to it. So then we got these industrial looking lamps from the store At Home as well. And I feel like it definitely would not be my dorm tour if I didn't have any of these like Christmas type or like twinkly lights around my room. So over here we have this 8x2 cubesicle kind of thing. I put this together. I'm very proud of myself because usually I have like Ryan help me or like do it because I'm just not good at like drilling and screwing and stuff like that. But we wanted to keep it kind of simple decorating it. So the first four cubes just has like succulents and kind of just like gold decor. And then on the third row, Charlotte has her books. And then on the bottom, we just have a basket each. So in mine, I just put like some swimsuits and just like bikini tops and bottoms because I had like nowhere else to put them. I really like having this here because it's right next to my bed. It can act like a nightstand and it's tall enough for me to have as a laptop or like TV stand because sometimes I just like fall asleep to watching Netflix or YouTube. So I like to just like put it on this. I literally have a fear of like knocking my computer off my bed. I just have heard some horror stories, so I'm hoping that's not gonna happen to me. Cubby is from Target, and then all the gold decor and succulents are from the store At Home. So then we have this really cute letterbox that I got from TJ Maxx over the summer, and I love changing the message. Right now we have MTV Welcome to My Crib, which I thought was really, you know, cute and funny. But this is actually hiding just like kind of like a mess over here. So I have this white tray that I just put like some miscellaneous stuff. I have a jewelry holder over here, which I don't have much jewelry because as you saw, I did have like a full jewelry hanger that I put most of my jewelry in. But this is definitely a cute decor item, so I wanted to hang like just like my everyday bracelets on it. And then I have some Tylenol because you never know when you might start getting cramps in bed and you just like want to reach over and grab Tylenol. And then I have my water bottle. I'm obsessed with my Hydro Flask. It keeps your drinks cold for like so long, and I feel like every company kind of says that, but like no, like Hydro Flask, like you do it the best. And then the last thing I have in this white tray is an SD card holder because sometimes I just get in the mood to like edit a video while in bed, so then I can just like grab it and start editing. So because my bed is so high up, I wanted to get a stool, and so I found this stool at TJ Maxx, and it was around like $30, not too bad. But you do have to be careful because it loses balance really easily. So I'm pretty sure I've fallen like 20 times or something since I've been here, which is like really embarrassing, and it's so stupid because I know I'm gonna fall. But it's just so cute and I can't get rid of it because like I love it so much. But now I want to move on to my wall decor, and I'm so excited to talk about this because like this is like the most fun kind of like decorating. So right here is a wall hanging I actually DIY'd. I used like this piece of wood that my mom found in like Hilton Head or something when I was like so young. It's just like petrified wood, so it feels like really smooth. So I literally remembered like this random stick. I was like, "Mommy, do you still have this stick?" And she did. So I wanted to use it and kind of like incorporate it in my room because I thought that was kind of sentimental. It's like my favorite piece of like wood. I don't know, that sounds weird, but like, it's cool, it's really cool. And then I just got the yarn from Michaels and it was really easy. I just like braided some pieces and then left some pieces alone. And I think it looks really cool because it's another pop of like that blush pink. So then on this shelf, I have this copper water bottle that my mom brought me back from India. She said if I drink from it, it's like good for me, but I tried and it hurt my teeth so bad. So I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna use it as like decor and it looks really good. And then I have this picture of a cactus. I took this when I was in LA and we were hiking to the Hollywood sign and it was just like a really cool view and it's a cactus, so it kind of like went with the theme. And then right next to it is a succulent I actually got from the Winter Park Farmers Market. But I'm really proud of myself because usually my plants die really soon because I just forget to water them. The jar that the succulent is in is from the store at home. The next shelf has another succulent. And again, I got it from Winter Park Farmers Market and the jar is from at home. And then this picture I also took with my iPhone 7 Plus. And this was in Arizona. I went there for a sorority convention over the summer. I think it's really cool that these pictures kind of mean something to me, even though they aren't like people in them. And by the way, all these shelves I got from Target, they came in like a 5-pack of like just different sizes. And it was all $35. So I feel like that's a pretty good price. And then over here, I have this painting that I actually did myself. It says, "Everybody loves a Georgia peach," because I kind of wanted to bring like my roots back into my room. And this frame is from the store at home as well.
So now I quickly want to do a little overview of my roommate's side. It's basically like the same thing, like the bedding and stuff like that. But then she put her own decorations on the wall. So it's kind of different, but just like the same kind of theme. And now I want to show you guys the bathroom. These actually just got redone this summer and I'm super lucky because they are beautiful. They're super modern. We decorated the bathroom putting like some mirror things up and then we put this vase in the middle of our two sinks with like fake roses in it and it just adds a little bit more to the space. Then we have a pocket door leading to the toilet and the shower. And I just put the extra toilet rolls on this cart that I got from TJ Maxx for super cheap in the clearance section. Then there are four shelves and each of the suite mates have their own and mine is definitely like the fullest, like because I just have so many products that I don't even like know what I have. And then we get into the shower where everyone has their own little space to put their shampoos and razors and stuff like that. And our shower is gorgeous. It literally looks like you're at a hotel. It's insane. And that is it of my room tour. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye guys!